安心者、切り捨て。
Hello and welcome to another Us vlog. In today's vlog, it's going to be a little bit shorter than usual. What we're going to do is we're going to basically, first and foremost, if you saw the previous vlog, you would have seen that we were actually talking about kidney health and how to cleanse your kidneys using basic, easy to use home remedy. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to be speaking with someone who knows a lot more about health and nutrition and herbal remedies, a lady by the name of Sophia, who we featured in a previous vlog, Sophia the Herbalist, and she's going to give you guys some information about what herbs you can use to help to heal your kidney and your liver. Us.
I'm Sophia, I'm a herbalist, and I've just been speaking with Benny and we're talking about herbs that are good for cleansing like your body, and I'm going to just tell you about a few kidney herbs that are going to cleanse your kidneys. So your kidneys are really really vital to your health. They filter your blood, and so if you don't take care of them, obviously you're not going to have good blood and a good body overall. So the first herb which is good for your kidneys is dandelion leaf. You might all know dandelion leaf, you see it everywhere. People call it a weed, they always pick it up because it grows everywhere. It gets in gardens and stuff like that. But dandelion leaf is amazing to cleanse your kidneys and your bowels in general, but mainly your kidneys. You can just take it, you can make it into a tea fresh, or you can dry the herbs so you have it, you know, for a long time and then make that into a tea. Another good one is Yuva Ursi. You might have heard of it, but again, it's good for your kidneys and your bladder. It just cleanses that whole system. There are also some herbs that are good, like that you have and you probably have in your kitchen and you put in your food. So like parsley. Parsley is amazing. It's really strong. Some people don't like it, but it's really good for your kidneys. It's got antiseptic properties and it just really gives your kidneys a good cleanse. You can have that like in teas, you can put it in your salads or eat it raw, how it is. Celery seed and celery root again are really good for your kidneys. Again, they have like a strong taste. A lot of the kidney herbs do have like a strong taste, but yeah, you get used to it. And as well as cleansing your kidneys, it's good to cleanse like your whole body in general. So like your liver, when people do a kidney cleanse, they also do a liver cleanse as well. Your liver's like your body's main detoxifying organ. So things like milk thistle, dandelion root especially. So when you get the dandelion leaf, if you dig it up a little bit, then you'll find the root, and that's what you can dry and boil a little bit and use, you know, as a liver cleanse. So dandelions you'll find in parks, most greens you'll find them in. I would say it's best to pick them away from like somewhere where there's like a road and a lot of pollution. So try and find like your nearest greenland or park that's away from like, you know, all the noise and city kind of thing like that, and then that's the best place to pick dandelion. Parsley, it's best to grow your own. I think parsley, you can get a little pot and then just perpetuate it, grow it. It can easily grow inside your house on your windowsill. And same with celery as well. If you've got a little plot of garden as well, you can just grow it. It grows really easily.
So it's not expensive to stay healthy.
Yeah, not expensive at all to stay healthy. A lot of these herbs are food-based anyway, and they're really cheap, especially to maintain it and perpetuate yourself. Really cheap to do it.
All right, wicked. Thank you very much for your time again, yeah?
I'll see you later. Yeah.
So yeah, hopefully that information will be of value to you guys. Definitely was of value to myself. A lot of things I found out that I didn't know already. What's the plan now? Why did I meet with Sophia? I met with Sophia, one, to get some good information for you guys, and two, because we're going to be putting together some like herbal loose leaf teas, and also some elixirs. I think that's how you pronounce it. And hopefully make them available for you guys online. And also on one of our Us Coconut stalls. So please look forward to that. And I'm looking forward to actually producing them, because I do feel as though, like we said, these things are readily available, easy, cheap, but the industry that we exist in, unfortunately, overcharge for things that are, you know, simple and easy to produce. So hopefully we'll be providing you guys with stuff that's affordable and, you know, well thought out, and you know, generally have a good impact on your health and your well-being. So this vlog today is going to be a little bit shorter than usual. What I wanted to kind of do, first and foremost, some couple people were hitting me up and asking me about, no wait, let me just show you this again. Betty the van, hear that? Smooth. Basically, like the last vlog, I was pushing a van up. Yeah, I was explaining the power of fasting. And a lot of people actually thought that was like some kind of like workout regime that I do, which is push my van. What I was actually doing is pushing the van because my starter motor didn't work. And every time, like for the whole last week, I've had to use the van, I've had to push it, either by myself, with the help of passing strangers, or with my with anybody who's been with me at the time. So I'm like really appreciating the privilege right now of being able to put a key in my ignition and start my van. So count your blessings, guys. You never know, yet something as simple as starting a van, you know, we take it for granted, but I experience pushing a van, you know, and there's countless other blessings that we have in our lives. So through this vlog, what I wanted to kind of do is update you guys on, first and foremost, our young warrior, Desmina. Her mother posted something recently on Instagram about how she's doing and give you guys an update. And I'm going to give you guys an update now on how she is doing herself. I'm just going to basically read what Desmina's mother wrote on Instagram. Okay, so this is an update from Desmina's mum. Just an update on our warrior. Des was scheduled to have chemo next week pending counts. Well, her platelets were only 19. So today she's receiving a platelet transfusion along with her antibiotics. Honestly, I'm relieved that she can have a small break from the chemo and hospital stay. She is just finally feeling better, and I would like her to enjoy her summer a bit without feeling crummy. Lately, we've been speaking with Johnny Bang Riley from Us, and he's been giving us great advice to help with all the toxicity she is receiving. We are blessed for this and all the support. We have been using her donation money for gas to and from the hospital. She has 1 to 2 visits a week, feeding her body as John has suggested, and for holistic treatments that her insurance will not cover. We hope to have a video update of our little warriors soon, when she is ready to be in front of the camera again. She is feeling a bit self-conscious about her hair being so thin. This is a picture from a couple of weeks ago before all of her hair loss. It is important that we respect her self-integrity and post only pictures and videos she approves. Thank you for all her supporters. Love beats cancer. So that's from Desmina's mother, and that's an update on the condition of our young warrior Desmina. So what I wanted to do is kind of just based on that is really urge you guys, you know, now more than ever, to please check out our online donations page, and that's at www.johnnybangriley.com/Desmina's Fund, where you can donate money directly to Desmina and her family. And also, I would like to kind of direct you guys to our online store, where 100% of the profits from our Kevin the Soul Assassin Ross signature line, everything from that goes to Desmina and her family. So please feel free to check out our online store. And you know what, like, hopefully together we can all, you know, chip in and work together to make a difference for this young warrior Desmina, because she deserves a break. And we're just going to keep on pushing through all these vlogs, through everything that we do, to kind of raise awareness, you know, for this young warrior and for this cause. So yeah, man, I wanted to kind of, yeah, just really stress that. Again, the links to our online store and our donations page will be at the end of this vlog. And I'll see you guys very soon. Try life. Awesome.